very simple. The Assassins existed something like 75,000 years ago, but a Brotherhood wasn't formed or so before Bayek was even born. That makes no sense and makes things too convoluted. Oh, I guess Darius was the Proto-Assassin before the Proto-Assassin. Aya killed Cleopatra with a snake, but according to the comics, it was suicide. Aya had the statue in the sanctuary, but not Bayek for unknown reasons, probably because Origins wasn't planned back then. The tombs are now shrines. The foundation of the Assassin Order in Egypt that will eventually lead towards AC1 happens at the last minute of the game. Bayek and Aya barely have a creed and don't even say nothing is true and everything is permitted.
There are rules. We are nothing if we do not abide by the Assassin's creed. What is it to transcend?
To recognize nothing is true and everything is permitted. That laws arise not from divinity but reason. I understand now that our creed does not command us to be free. It commands us to be wise.
And our kingdom needs no crowns. What we believe in, our values, our creed, will unify us.
And stay your tongue.
They are so far removed from the original tenets and ideology, this can just be called a new franchise. The rituals are handled poorly. Aya just gets the hidden blades and kisses to Bayek, which they keep cause, well, it's actually pretty freaking handy if you want to kill your targets. But Odyssey reveals that she is related to Darius and Cassandra. First off, what the fuck? Why wasn't this mentioned in Origins? Also, this means that Aya has a huge First Civilization DNA concentration, as she is a descendant of the hybrid Cassandra. People with higher Isu concentration have more control over the artifacts, but in Origins, none of this is mentioned. She has a child with Bayek, who wielded the Apple of Eden once, but what's the point of giving them a huge First Civilization power boost if they do nothing with it? The Animus is a lying machine now. First off, in the beginning of the series, the Animus could only show the true history of the world.
Sometimes it seems wrong. Untrue, like the history is off somehow. It doesn't
what, Mr. Miles? Match up with what you read on an online encyclopedia? What your high school history teacher taught you? Let me ask you something. Do these supposed experts have access to secret knowledge kept hidden from the rest of us?
There are books, letters, documents, all sorts of source material from back then. Some of it seems to contradict what the Animus is showing me.
Anyone can write a book, and they can put whatever they want on its pages. Anything. Used to be, we thought the world was flat.
Some people still do.
Yes, and they publish books about it. Or that the moon landing was a hoax. I believe there's also a book claims the world was created in 7 days. A bestseller, too.
Where's this going, Doc?
The point, I suppose, is that you shouldn't trust everything you hear, everything you read. What's that your ancestors said? Nothing is true.
Everything is permitted.
Yes, exactly.
Our creed!
Stay your tongue, unless I give you leave to use it.
But now it makes guesswork on extrapolated memories, which means the Animus shows things that are fiction and non-fiction at the same time, complicating what is fact inside the Animus and what isn't fact. The AC Odyssey novel is the official canon story. You need to read the book to understand everything that happens in Assassin's Creed Odyssey.
You are gods.
No, not God. We simply came before. No, not God. We simply came before.
Genetic memory started off really simple by taking blood samples of the individual who's descendant of the ancestor. Or you just lie down like in AC1. However, we can now extract genetic memories of dead people, and I mean people who are dead for over 2,000 years.
What the fuck?
I can almost taste the blood.
What the
Okay, you're making less and less sense.
Oh, I almost forgot to mention that if you want to understand why people still use the Animus instead of Helix, well, just read the novels. What next? We need to use Yoka to access genetic memories? The Assassin's Creed is barely present in the games. EcoVision has no limits. It has no boundaries. It's literally magic without a system. It can do anything the writers and programmers want wanted to do. Now we have people like Bayek who have a symbiotic connection with animals, which is barely explained. The Assassin's Creed movie is filled with contradictions towards the established lore. Why are the majority of the characters so goddamn sexy? Wait, what? Ezio for some reason has a precursor box in possession, even though he wants nothing to do with this anymore.
Get out!
The wind! It opens the door!
40!
Artifacts like the precursor box stay around for a few games to be never seen and heard of again. Since when are the Assassins and the Templars the Force? Why are they described as chaos versus order? Well, this is a Saturday morning cartoon for children. I thought this series is about freedom versus control, or freedom versus security, or whatever, everything except that. The biggest misconception that players actually have about the Assassin Order is that they want absolute chaos, but that's not what they want at all. They are okay with government, society, whatever, but now the Assassins and Templars are some balance in the universe? What?
Use the staff. Repair the rift in the universe.
My friends and I are trying to keep it out of the hands of the Templar Order.
Listen to me. Order? Chaos? If either triumphs alone, the world dies. I tried to bring an end to chaos, and it has only led to ruin.
I used to assist order. Now I fight for choice, freedom, chaos.
Actually, calling the Assassins Agents of Chaos, or whatever, is Templar propaganda. Connor was the first Native American assassin, until this prequel character came out of nowhere. Why was Shay never mentioned before? No, better question yet, why wasn't he in AC3? Rebecca survived the ending of AC Syndicate, but you only find it out through the young adult novels, the second one in the trilogy.
Abstergo is a big company. It's too big, which means there were slip-ups, you know, like that mess they're having right now with the fluoride.
Abstergo has issues with secrecy, so the wise decision to counter leaks is to hire ordinary people to make video games on genetic memories that is based on the Assassin Templar conflict. And these people have nothing to do with the shadowy war that has been going on for thousands of years. Juno is the next big threat. She has multiple games building her up as the main antagonist, so she can be completely forgotten later, and her story gets resolved in a comic book series called Uprising. Apples of Eden turn people into monsters.
What?
This word of God. You understand now? Red Sea was never parted. Water never turned to wine. It was not the machinations of Iris that spawned the Trojan War, but this! Illusions! All of them!
They were used to command, to control, to own.
Now shall you deal with me, O prince, and all the powers of hell!
I guess Ezio never learned that trick. All the main characters get forgotten and don't seem to be important. Origins reveals the empirical truth that the AC universe is some kind of Matrix simulation. It shares the theme from The Matrix Reloaded, to be exact here. In Assassin's Creed lore, this means the total catastrophe that Desmond and his friends stopped back in 2012 has only delayed the apocalypse for a time. Because the universe is trying to correct itself. Fuck it, I'm done. Fuck this sunk cost fallacy.